Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to make sure that I'm using indentations and tab stops properly for bulletin numbered lists. Okay, so I'm working on this report template, and I'm using the guide over at University of Wellington as a sample that I can rely on. Now, they do have a section on here. Check this out. So they've got a checklist, which is basically just a bulleted list. And notice that the bullets are lined up with the title, or this heading, Appendix A. But on Appendix B, bullets, even though they're different styles, are not properly lined up, and they really should be. We can see it a little further on when they get into an example on the same page here. Let me find it. Here we go. So in a sample of an executive summary, we can see that we've got these sections, purpose and method, and then findings or recommendations for increasing, and the bullets are not lined up. It's an easy mistake to make, but it's also pretty easy to solve. So let's make sure that we can figure that out so that we don't make the same mistake. I'm just going to move down in my sample document to a section. Introduction is good as any. And I'm going to go ahead and select my paragraph, and I'm going to put in a fake paragraph. I'll just use lorem ipsum text, one paragraph with 12 sentences. There we go. And now I'm going to create a series of paragraphs using the lorem function again. This time I'm going to do six paragraphs with two sentences each. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because now I can easily select it and just go ahead and convert it to a bulleted list. And that's what bulleted lists are. They are simply a series of paragraphs. If I had my formatting marks turned on, we would see that at the end of each paragraph, whether it's a traditional length paragraph or a bulleted list, we have these little paragraph symbols at the end. That indicates it's the end of a paragraph and a new paragraph is starting. You can also see a few other things. For instance, these little arrow symbols here. If you're familiar with these arrow symbols in Word, that means a tab was hit. It's kind of weird. You're like, a tab stop. You'll see it down here. If I type in some text and then press my tab key, I get that little arrow, more text, tab key, more text. So the arrow is an indicator that a tab was pressed. I don't really need that. And it's good to know how this is working. Now, as soon as I click on any of these list items, you're going to start to see some indicators on the ruler that give me some insight. I'm going to go ahead and select all of my bulleted list items, and we'll see that we've got kind of like a hanging indent. The first line indent marker lines up with the bullets themselves. The hanging indent marker lines up with the text. And if I were to move that hanging indent around, you could start to see that we can certainly control where that text is, and my tab stop's getting a little further away. If I were to click in between those, that would basically customize the default tab that they have in there, and you can see as I move that tab stop left and right, that's also affecting the text. I'm going to go ahead and move that away. So what I'll do first is I'm going to move my hanging indent left and right, and that of course controls the bullets, and I'm going to line that up with the left edge of the text. So I'll line up the bullets right there. Now I can move the hanging indent, just click and drag, move that left and right, and I'll move that a little further to the left. Now, by default, we want the tab stop, which is already set in here, is basically going to be aligned with the hanging indent. So if you're using an older version of Microsoft Word, you probably actually see that little tab indicator right in there, and unless it's an unusual situation, that tab is going to be right where the left indent is. I can't see it on this particular version of Word 2019, but I know that it's there because I can see those tab stops, and I can easily pop in my own tab and move it where I want it to be. I've got two, so let me get rid of that one. And we'll see it's kind of just, this is what it would look like in an older version, but within two steps I can move the tab, and then I can move the hanging indent. Oops, now I accidentally moved the full indent, no big deal. So I'll just grab my first indent and bring that over. It takes a little bit of finesse here because these are so tiny to click on. There is a left indent, which is basically a little square underneath. Then you've got the little house triangle symbol. That's the hanging indent. And I've got the left, the first line indent. So there's a lot of things going on in this ruler. But once you get that mastered, it's going to be no problem creating bulleted lists later on. As an experiment, I'll just move on down here. I'll create another section of random. I'll just do some lorem text. I'll do five paragraphs with three sentences each. Go ahead and select all of these. I'll make them a bulleted list. And even if I want to change those bullets, I can, of course, customize and change the bullet style. Now, before I do that, though, I can see that it's gone back to its default alignment. There is a way to change the styles in here, which I'm not going to do, but for this part of the document, we could easily copy some formatting that we like, use the format painter, apply that to the next one, and now all of our bullets will have the same formatting, which is good. You want them to be consistent. I could change these out, though, to checkbox items if I want to, but once again, then I could go through and adjust exactly where I want that text to be so that it lines up with all of my other bulleted lists. So the key to this is just being aware of the first line indent, hanging indent, and any tab stops. Those are what control the alignment of your bulleted list, and numbered list, by the way, are exactly the same.